Anthony, last few times we saw you, you had obviously your car robbed in Ilford, and then it was your birthday. Today, what's the mood like?
The mood's always good for me, man. The mood's always good. Even when my car got broken into, still in good spirits, because we're still training, we still got opportunity, and we're still living life, so we're happy.
The head-to-head got a little bit heated there. Can you just tell us what was said?
What between me and Lyndon? I forgot what he said to me. That's what I'm saying. He's talking now. But before he wasn't really talking. He said something like, "You don't want to look away because you think I'm good looking or something like that." I said, "What? I don't understand what he said." And I said, "You're talking because you're nervous." And he goes, "I'm not nervous." He goes, "The first fight, I wanted to fight you." I was like, "Yeah, I'm the biggest name. I was the biggest name, so of course that's what you want to do. Just like me, I want to fight world champions." And that's what we're literally always talking about. But I'm just telling him that he's acting up because he's nervous. They were very open and they didn't want the rematch. They'd done everything they could to get out of the rematch. But it's here.
What do you think makes Lyndon nervous about this fight?
His trainer said it in the change room after the first fight. They know how I'm going to come for the next fight. And that's it, in plain sight. They know how I'm coming. And again, it's like his trainer has predicted how the next fight's going to go. He said he knew it wasn't me in there. It was a very, very close fight. And he knows I'm going to come for the next fight. So he's going to do everything he can to make the next fight not happen. That's exactly what he said. And he's admitted it. He did say that it was a close fight. He thought that Lyndon just about won. But it was a close fight. He kept saying it was a close fight. But all that matters is the future now, isn't it? They know how I'm coming for the next fight, and I don't think they can stop it.
In the 12th round, you had some success against Lyndon. Is it going to be exactly how you come out in the first round, or is it going to be slightly more tactical?
Exactly. So this is what I'm trying to say. And literally, people are acting like this fight, he beat me up and he won every round. It was a split decision. So clearly, I was seeing it from one way, and the other two judges were seeing it from another way. One of the judges gave it to me by 5 rounds. The other two judges gave it to him by 1 round. It's perspective. That happens in boxing all the time. There's so many times we watch fights and everyone's arguing, saying, "Nah, he won. It was a split decision. So unfortunately for me, that's something that goes on the record. But again, I've got opportunity to right the wrong.
There's going to be a crowd at this one. Is that going to make a big difference?
It's always going to be a difference. It's always going to be a difference. I'm looking forward to it. I'm really looking forward to, again, having a crowd back. The atmosphere, it's going to feel like a boxing match again. Not just sparring or coasting and practicing things.
And obviously, Tindy decided to take some limelight today as well. I know you particularly enjoy it when that happens. What did you make of the trainers clashing on stage?
I said what I said to Pat. I just felt like, you know, there's no need for it. We're here as role models. Like, I'm a role model, Lyndon's a role model, Pat's a role model, Tunde's a role model. And I don't really see myself as a role model. I don't like to see myself as a role model. But as much as I don't want that and I don't like it, there's kids that watch me. You know, there's adults that watch me. And there's a lot of people that said to me, "Look, I know where you've come from." And there's people that know me as well saying, "I know what you used to be like. You've changed your life around." So they respect it. So it's like, we've all been there. Like, we don't need to talk about what we've done. I'm sure that these lot, they were in Manchester, whatever, they've done what they've done. You don't need to go back to that. It's childish to even go back to that kind of mindset.
Why is the fight in London, not in Manchester?
As far as I know, that was a decision made by promoters or promoter and people in the background. That was nothing to do with me. Everyone knows how I get it cracking. I went to Russia to fight. I don't care about where I'm fighting. I've fought in Manchester before. For me, it was, my assumption of why it's in London is because I've got a bigger fan base. I will sell out an arena a lot easier than he would sell out somewhere in Manchester. He's got his little cheerleaders around him, which is fantastic to have a little support system. But in terms of selling out things and having a fan base or selling out an arena, he's a boring fighter. He's an effective fighter, but he's a boring fighter. I'm more entertaining. So that's, I think, why I ended up being in London. Nothing to do with me.
Sonny Edwards told us last time that when you were fighting that he was talking to you in the ring and you could listen to him and you were getting annoyed by it. What do you make of that?
Sonny Edwards is a cheerleader. He's a world champion, but he's a cheerleader. I don't know the boy. I've never really had conversation with him. I'm more cool with his brother. But again, it's boxing, isn't it? That's his boy. Lyndon's his boy, and he's doing the right thing. I didn't even know it was him. I could hear people, because again, that's what I'm saying. When you're fighting behind closed doors, it's like you're having a sparring match. I'm used to hearing little noise or whatever, but that was the opportunity. And again, I'm happy for Lyndon, the fact he got like some limelight or whatever, but I'm taking my position back, because I'm a crowd fighter.
And finally, can I just get a prediction from you of what happens on December 4th?
A better fight than the first fight. And a victory for Anthony Yarde.
Is it going to be a knockout for Anthony Yarde?
Again, you know, everyone that knows me knows that's what I go for. I feel like anyone that watches boxing, that's what they watch the boxing for. They wait for that result. They wait for the fact how it's going to finish or whatever. No one really likes to watch a long 12-round fight. I'm talking about casual boxing fans. So that's always what I'll go for when an opportunity presents itself.